of the Governing Council of the Mountains of the Moon University have today held a crisis meeting to discuss ways of ending the ongoing industrial action by university lecturers and support staff. The crisis meeting was held at the university's Saka campus, and our correspondent was there and spoke to officials on what was resolved.
The meeting was attended by Tom Butime, the chairperson of the university's governing council, his vice Oswald Ndolerire, Professor Pius Coxwell, the chairperson of the transition task force, University Chancellor Professor Edward Rugumayo, and Vice Chancellor Professor John Kasenene, among others.
To remove this misunderstanding between management and the staff on simple issues.
Vice Chancellor Professor John Kasenene stated that the industrial action, which started on the 2nd of August, has greatly disturbed the functionality of the university.
What happened since 2nd of September, no, 2nd of August, and now we are in September. They were not very good events because they disturbed the functionality of the university. The teaching, learning, research, examinations, and other programs.
Governing Council Chairperson Tom Butime said some of the issues that led to the industrial action are beyond the university's top governing body.
That's that. There have been meetings, there has been a lot of correspondence between the staff and top management of the university. So there has been a ping pong, isn't it? But these matters needed to be solved. Not necessarily at Saka campus, isn't it? But also in Kampala, Ministry of Education.
Pius Coxwell, the university's transition task force chairperson, has assured the university management of a government takeover.
I take this opportunity to give my thanks to my seniors in terms of leadership here for having worked so tirelessly with the support, with the staff, who by all means had genuine reasons to go industrial action, because somebody does that because it's a cause, and we don't take that lightly. But they have accepted now to get back to work, to open the university, and to me that's the best way. Now, we sincerely apologize to parents, guardians, sponsors for all the time lost, but we are open for 15th, and we are inviting all students to come aboard.
Professor Kasenene has assured the striking university staff and lecturers of their pay.
But the Office of the Auditor General assessed how we accumulated this money, said, oh, General MME, don't worry. We shall pay this money as soon as the university is taken over. And actually, I have the report in my office, if you can see. All these arrears to hold on, their money is safe and they will get it.
Governing Council Chairperson Butime has asked the staff and lecturers to immediately resume work.
The university, the staff, everybody should be back. That one. But henceforth, isn't it? The other demand, other issue, isn't it? Will follow. But for the purpose of the students of this country, our children must continue with their education, isn't it?
Othbert Alinda, the University Guild president, said as students, they have been patiently waiting to receive services from the university.
We have been patiently waiting for this industrial action to an end. We as students have been too patient to receive services again. As you are all aware, we are here for services, mainly for academics, and I hope once this industrial action ends, we are going to resume, and I'm going to present to my constituents about the results from the resolution, for resolutions from the council, as you have heard from previous speakers, this meeting, the last meeting which we had for the council, it was mainly to conclude the industrial action.
Report by Roger Sunday for the news.